course, after I did it, I mean, it was absolutely addicting to me.
Everything was new. We were inventing things as we went along.
It's so incredibly on the edge and dangerous.
These girls actually, it was their lifestyle.
Because everything's an obstacle to you. You know, like, we have like different eyes compared to other people.
Of course we're gonna do it because it's such a thrill. And we wanted to do it because we knew nobody else was doing it.
Everyone was always pushing the limits and everyone was always trying to do something no one else had done.
Most of us were outcasts, you know what I mean?
Back then it was always underground.
You know, weren't popular. Didn't, you know, usually the poorer kids.
We didn't want it to be mainstream.
We used to travel around in a pack and terrorize the town.
So if you got into it, you really felt like you were part of an underground subculture, music, fashion, ways of thinking.
Oh, yeah. So let's rock and roll all night and party every day!
That was the only training that that surfers really did back then. We didn't jog and we didn't work out, we didn't lift weights, you know, it was just surfing. And so when there was no surf, then we did the skateboards.
Oh, well, this was a whole, this was an alternative to surfing. As far as we were concerned, everything, all the moves we made, I know we were riding waves in our minds.
The 60s are over. Vietnam War had ended finally. People were more free than they've ever been, more experimental than they've ever been. The involvement of women in everything.
It changed from being an all-around skater to vertical riding and pool riding and all that being the number one thing.
If you wanted to get respect, you'd almost have to get more aggressive, more ballsy with your tricks or clitty.
If we heard about a pool, we'd all jump in the car, we'd just go.
For me, it was being radical and doing stuff no other girl was doing and then do it with style.
Skateboarding just like took it, just took the cake with me. It's never stopped. I'm like addicted now.
There's something about another girl doing it, like that just really touches a spot where you're like, whoa, if she can do it, I can do it, because she's just like me.
It's just something about the energy, you know? I mean, it's important for me to have girls to be skating with and that are pushing the limits.
And then if one of us got it, we all had to try it. We all had to get it. But we were all really different women.
They didn't like your skating. They said you were skating like a boy.
And they were like, oh no, like you can't skate.
It's like I had to get shut down so hard for so long and I kept skating. I did not care. I was still gonna do it.
We didn't care what anybody else thought. It just didn't matter.
You know, one chick skater in a pack of 20 guys, sometimes you do need your back washed a little bit.
This is it, man. This chick is ripping on us, blowing us away here. 20 years in the making, and here it is.
It's like my life, like a skate. It's like what I do.
This is my life, and this is like what I'm gonna be doing for the next, like, hopefully 20 years.
Skateboarding is just my life. It's what I do. It's what I live for.
Whenever I think of who I am and what I am, I always think of skateboarding.
Anything, I used to tell myself, anything I do after skateboarding will be piece of cake. Anything. And that's the way it's been.
How long do you think you'll keep doing it?
Till I can't. Yeah. Till I can't.